Michael Berger, IT manager of University of Tennessee and Knoxville campus.
Thank you. I said I'm Mike Berger. I'm the IT manager, but I'm really an audio video guy. The classroom technology at the university came from the video department, and then we got incorporated into the IT department. So that's a little bit of change from what a lot of schools do, but we've got a background in video. I've been dealing with video at the university since 86, so I've been there a while. We started centrally funding classroom technology in 2002, and I've been involved with Wolf Vision in some form or fashion since about 2004. So, been there a while, seen a lot of changes, seen a lot of changes in the visualizer. We're very much up front with the Sign app, where we had a beta version of it, and did a lot of testing with that, and moved forward and seen a lot of progression, a lot of changes in that product through that time.
So you've, at this point, implemented over the last 4 years something like over 100 classrooms with Sign app technology?
Yeah, we're somewhere in that neighborhood, 125 to 150 classrooms with one version or the other of the Sign app.
Okay. And so prior to leveraging the Sign app, what did your classroom technology look like, and what was it sort of lacking that you've added to it since?
One of the things that we really lacked was that ability to walk around the room. We had that, especially instructors that teach in large rooms wanted to get out from behind that lectern, because when you're sitting especially some of these large lecture halls, and you're sitting there behind a lectern, people tend to fall asleep. You get up and start moving around and start interacting with them, people pay more attention. So that was one of the things that we were really looking for. Prior to that time, I mean, we're like many other universities. You had a connection on the podium. You had a document camera. We did not implement computers in the classroom, so they were bringing their own device anyway. So for us, the BYOD was a long time ago, but it was a different definition of what most people refer to it as now.
So they're using. A major part of it was the Sign app was being used, that they could then bring their PowerPoint or their lecture and freely move about the space while the wireless is presented to our device.
Yeah.
That was the first part.
Yeah, for probably a couple of years before we implemented it, we were getting requests from faculty asking for, we want to get out behind here. And we looked at different technologies. Security was a concern. How do we keep people from just displaying whatever they want, because students are very creative, let's put it that way. So we were concerned about that. We were concerned about its impact on our network and our network being able to manage it. Especially on a wire, you run an enterprise wireless network on campus where you've got multiple networks. It's making that seamless, making that to be able to work across the networks, but also be able to limit what it's, to certain areas. So those were concerns.
And regarding the wireless, you mentioned something yesterday about how you were dealing with the wireless broadcasting, and because you mentioned sometimes organizations, when you walk in and you go to wirelessly present, you'll see like a thousand different options, and you have a creative way of addressing that.
Yeah, one of the things that we did, and it was actually, that was actually a result of when we initially had put it on our network, we were having a little bit of problem with the AirPlay staying connected. So our solution to that, while they were working on resolving that, and Wolf Vision, between Wolf Vision and Aruba, they were able to kind of get everything together and get that resolved. But what we did in the meantime was, when we turned the system off, through our control system, we turned off all the wireless stuff, the AirPlay, the Chromecast, the Miracast, we turned all that off. What we found was that was actually a good thing, because we've got buildings that we've got, I may have 20 of these in a building. And while we have limited the AirPlay and those things, the discovery to that building, if you're going in, you're seeing a lot of devices. So by turning the devices off, turning all that AirPlay stuff off when the system was off, is minimized how many things people were actually seeing. So they were only seeing the units that were actually turned on. So we actually found that, to be a bonus, even though that wasn't the intention of when we originally did it.
And I think that actually kind of parlays into the next thing I want to ask you about. But basically what you're doing is you're using a third-party control system in that scenario, and you're able to turn off the broadcasting
yes.
of the sign-up, which we couldn't do with an Apple TV, I don't think. I mean, I don't know if we can set
no,
it to stop.
Yeah, you can't. In my knowledge, you can. I'm not as excessively familiar with those. But, yes, anything that you can control with the interface, I can control with the control system, which has been very helpful to us because we can, when you turn the system off, we can, a lot of times instructors will walk out of the room and they'll forget to log out of stuff. And for us, that's important because we run the Office 365 app on them. So they're logged into it. So we can basically force it into a new presentation whenever the system is turned off.
And then when I mentioned the parlay, so I also appreciated what you shared recently about this matter of introducing faculty to a new user interface. And we're really proud of what our development team created. Mm-hmm. It's very simple, but you mentioned yesterday about how you've given faculty a choice, whether
right.
they use our interface or the control system. Can you talk about that a
yeah,
little?
One of the things that when we first looked at this, the first thing Wolf Vision introduced us is, you know, this could be your centerpiece of the room. You don't need all this other stuff. Well, for us, we still did, even though we're going to be transitioning, because one of the things when you have a large, many number of classrooms as we have, is you want some consistency from room to room. You don't want to throw them into entirely new stuff with a new interface, with a new that, where they have to go in and learn, and they may only teach one class in that room and then have to go to another room. So we gave them all the same functionality they had before with the user interface that looks, you know, very much like they had before, with the addition of it's got some controls for the sign app. If they don't want to use them, they've still got all the buttons they had before. So people could gradually start to learn how to use it without having to come in and be prepared that first day to learn a whole new system. So we are gradually implementing that. And one of the things I was talking about a little bit yesterday too was we've got three rooms that we're doing that we are not putting any other switching gear in it this year. They're much simpler rooms. We're doing a 75-inch touchscreen. A sign app. We're still doing a VGA and an HDMI input, so those that want to do a laptop, but we are actually running it through the sign app. We're doing a control system in there so they can control it with the control system, much like they've been doing for a long time, but they can also do it without it, and they can do it completely through the Wolf Vision controls. And this is kind of that next step of getting people more transitioned into another user interface so we can start maybe doing away with some of these large matrix switchers and basically making that bundle in the room a little bit smaller, which is, you know, a cost saving.
That's fantastic. And I just have one more question for the sake of those who've joined us. What would you say to other learning institutions that are considering deploying Wolf Vision sign app technology in their classrooms?
Well, it has really matured. I mean, we started off very early in the process, and, you know, when you're on the front end of things, and you said, well, you had a beta version of it, there was a lot of learning. There was a lot of learning for us, there was a lot of learning for Wolf Vision, but it's a very mature product now, even though it continues to add new features and stuff, but very easy to implement, and you don't have to do it all at once. You know, what you introduce faculty to it, staff to it, and let them transition to it. You know, if you try to force them into doing this, it's not going to work. You've got to let them transition into doing it at their speed.
That's fantastic. Well, Michael, we thank you so much for your partnership with Wolf Vision over the
yeah,
years.
Yeah.
And thank you so much for joining us this morning.